Hello everyone, I am Kota Singh and today we will be learning about Android Jetpack navigation. So let's create the project in Android Studio. As you can see, I'm using Android Studio Preview, which is in orange color. The older version of it is in green color. It is a preview or beta version, you can say. It can be downloaded. I'll show you how. But let's first make the project because Gradle build takes time. So let's give the name Android Studio Jetpack Tutorials. Let's press next, and the main thing in it, we have to select activity and fragment view model instead of empty activity or blank activity. So press next, finish. The Gradle bit takes time, and I'll show you from where you can download it. Just write Android Studio Preview in Google search and open the first link and download it from over here, the Canary build. As you can see, it is available for Windows and Linux as well. Now let's go to Google and write Android Studio Jetpack. This is the thing which we'll be learning. Jetpack is nothing but it is all the features combined in under one roof, under one name, which is called Jetpack. So there's like so many components like foundation, architecture, UI, and many other things. So in architecture today, we will be learning about navigation. As you can see, Android KTS. Android KTS, very nice extension functions for and Kotlin developers. But today we will be talking about navigation. And there are so many things like paging and room, view model, everything. Room we will be talking about in next lecture most probably, but if you want that I should make this video on this topic first, then please comment down below. So I will make the video on that topic first. So now let's check if it's our Gradle builder has completed. Yes, it has completed yet. So we have three things over here: main fragment, main view model, and main activity. We won't be needing main view model. We will work with main fragment and main activity only. Let's create a new fragment. So, because we will be playing with fragments. First fragment. Finish. Yeah, let the Gradle build complete. Till then, we will learn more about navigation. So click on that and you will get on this page. And on the left side, you can see implement navigation. So you click on that, you will get this page over here. So over here, as you can see, adding components to your project. This is a very important page. From this page, we have to add three lines of code in a Gradle file. So because it's a dependency for the navigation part. The Gradle has not yet been completed. So let's come to migrate to navigation architecture component. In this thing, they will explain you why they're using navigation instead of activity switching. Let's take example of money transfer app. Let's from home screen, you have to go to send money screen. So everything, what happens in the life cycle is your activity is destroyed, activity is paused, and then a new activity is created, which takes a bit time. And all the similar features like your drawer layout or menu, every code has to be written again in the different activity. So this takes a lot of time as if we switch from activity A to activity B. But in this case, there is only one activity, but the main content, the main part, which is of home screen to send money screen, is changing. That's it. The other part, or which is on the top or which is at the bottom, sometimes like they are just changing. So we'll take this example. Suppose this is a main activity. Only this will be fixed. The upper part will be fixed, but the lower part will be changing by fragment one and fragment two. So suppose we have to switch to home screen or send money screen. The main activity part will be fixed, but that screen will be replaced by fragment one and again fragment two. So I hope you are getting and understanding it. If you're not, please comment down below. I will be happy to help you. So let's check Gradle. Yeah, it takes this Android Studio takes a bit of time comparatively to the previous one. We will paste the copied code to the Gradle file so that we can get the libraries of the navigation part. This thing takes a bit of time. So so let's come back over here. You want to read about anything else like in Android Studio Jetpack, you can directly read from over here. They have given a good documentation but quite complex. Next tutorial I will be making is on Room, as I already told you. So till then, most probably it will come in 1 or 2 days maximum. And I have tutorials in Hindi as well. So if you are fluent in Hindi or you understand better in Hindi, then I will give the link in the description of the Hindi tutorial as well. And please do let me know if you guys want Hindi tutorial first or English tutorial. Yeah, our Gradle build has been completed. So we will make one more fragment called the second fragment. And don't forget to uncheck these include fragment factory. Don't forget this thing and the include interface callbacks. Don't forget to uncheck these. Finish. It takes a bit of time. I'll fast forward it. Yeah, so it's completed. So now we will create our navigation graph. People will be familiar with if they are familiar with iOS thing, then they will be familiar with this as well. So let's go to the main activity and change the fragment to draw a layout. Fragment match parent. This is common. The three main lines will be coming next. First, Android name. Yeah, we should let's give the ID first. ID my underscore fragment Android name Android Android X and X dot navigation dot, don't worry about the red things, it will be gone, these are not errors. Fragment dot nav host fragment. So this is basically telling it that this is a navigation host fragment, means it will be hosting the navigation part. Now we will write app. Yeah, first we will close it, then we will create a new resource from Android resource file. We will change the resource type to navigation. Don't forget to change the resource type to navigation. It is very important. You will name it nav graph, or you can name it anything, which or whatever suits you. But I will be naming nav graph, and please make sure you click on the navigation part. So let's go to the design part of it. Yes, this is the coolest interface Android has ever built, and it helps a lot, trust me, for big projects. So we will get a main fragment, and yes, in main activity we will add those two more lines which are necessary. We'll import the app by alt enter. So app nav graph, we will give where our nav graph is available, like we will give the ID of it. At the rate navigation slash nav graph. Yeah, nav graph. So only one more line. See, this is a boilerplate code. You have to write it always when you are creating a fragment in the main activity. But for the rest of them, it's a completely drag and drop. So you don't have to worry about it. So we are setting if it's a default nav host, then it's true. That's it for the code. So let's switch to the the main activity. Let's delete the code. This is of not our use. And yeah, so we will be making a drawer layout. First of all, drawer colon drawer layout. Then we will make host. This is equal to support fragment manager, and find fragment by ID. We will give the ID of the fragment which we created in the main activity XML file. My fragment, it is coming red. Let's check what was the name of it. It was my fragment only. Let's copy and paste it, maybe because of that. And no, it's just I think it's just the IDE or compiler issue. We will fix it. We let's not worry about it. Let's check. It's same only. So let's go ahead. Let's go ahead. And as nav host fragment, it can be null. So we will take care of the null pointer exception. If it's null, then we'll return it. Now we will create the nav controller from the host. Nav controller basically which will be controlling your navigation bar, and it will be interacting with your drawer layout as well. We'll initialize the drawer layout, find view by id r dot id dot what was it, container. Okay, container. So now we will link the nav controller and the drawer layout with our action bar. So navigation UI, make sure you write UI, set up action bar with nav controller. The first argument is the parameter text is the activity, second is the nav controller, and the third is the drawer layout. Now we'll write on support navigation up. In this case, if what will happen if the user press the back button, and what is to be done. So you have to tell it. So navigation UI, navigate up, it will take the draw layout and nav controller. We will choose navigation dot find nav controller, this dot this this r dot id dot okay, it's comma over here, make sure you put the comma, r dot id dot my fragment. I don't know what's wrong with this my fragment, but let's figure out something. Let's same only. Let's put it up. It won't make any difference, I know, but just in case, let's change the name to the fragment. No, it's still not working. So let's build the project. Let's build the project and wait for it. I'll fast forward it. Yeah, that was a completely compiler or IDE issue or whatever you can say. So now it's done. Let's go to NavGraph, the design part. The design part, they have made it amazing, totally amazing. It was in iOS before. Now, like it was in iOS. It is there in iOS still. It's still there in iOS. If you're familiar with the iOS development. It is kind of similar to it, but the functionalities are quite different over here. But it gives you a very nice overview how the activities or fragments are connected. Most basically, fragments are connected with each other, and so it's very easy to link the fragments with each other. The main thing is over here is the action ID. It's fragment. Okay, if you click on the arrow part, then you get the action, the ID action. So idea of the action, this is the very main part, and we will be using it to navigate from one page to another. Let's go to the design part of it. Let's add two buttons so that we can navigate from first fragment, main fragment to first and second fragment. I hope you are familiar with it. I just fast forwarded so that it's not a, we don't have to deal with boring stuff. We will call a method called onViewCreated. We will work everything in, like, we have to work everything in that only. So we will set the onClick listeners on the buttons. So it's not directly, but we have to do it like view.findViewById. And then we'll give the button, because it's a button, r.id button. Again, it's just a compiler issue, don't worry about it. Once we will build it, it will be gone. It was button only, right? Yeah, it was button only. It's just, again, it's a compiler issue only. So let's come down. Over here, we'll write navigation. You know, this Android Studio is comparatively quite slow. It's slower than the previous one. It is quite buggy as well, as you can see. But in near future, I think Google will work out to make it stable. That's why they have not introduced the update in stable release. You have to download it separately from the website I showed you. Go to navigation bar and copy the ID of it. And we will paste it over there. A main fragment. As you can see, it's navigation find view controller. It means the view, then navigate r.id, then action ID, and then we'll copy it and we'll paste it for the second button as well. We'll change it to button 2, nav graph, then again the action ID, we'll copy and paste. You know, we get some amazing animations when we are going from one fragment to another fragment. I won't show it. I won't be able to show that thing in this tutorial because it will take a lot of time. So, see, as you can see, I built the Gradle and all the button errors are gone. It's just the ID and compiler issue. Just don't worry about it. It won't affect it. And just whenever it comes and you're sure that you have copied the exact ID, just build the project. It won't bother you. It took me like 2 hours to find out what's wrong with it. Then I ultimately built the project and it was like, oh man, it's working. So don't be scared. And if any problem anywhere, just let me know. So we are on the second fragment. We'll just name it second. And on the first fragment, we'll just make it first for our better understanding. Yes, so let's see if there is any error. Let's run the app. Let's see if there's any error. I'll fast forward it. And yes, so our app is running. As you can see, when I click on it, it goes to the different fragment instead of the whole activity is loading. As you can see, the animation of the button, back button, and the draw layout symbols, it's everything is coming within like 4 to 5 lines, so maybe 5 to 6 lines, that's it. Now let's change the main the heading of it, it was written over there, main fragment and first fragment. So we'll click on the main fragment and it will come over here, label, then we'll change it to something home, and over here we'll change it to first, and similarly we'll change the second fragment to second. It took me like four hours to figure out how to change the name. It was so stupid. The documentation is not well documented. So that's why it was very difficult for me to check the names. So as you can see, it has changed to home and it has changed to first in this fragment. And over here it's second. So this is completely amazing. And I will be making one more tutorial very soon. So if you want to know about any of the Jetpack component, just please let me know in the comment. And till then, stay tuned. Tata, bye bye.